Alright, hello guys, welcome to another video. Today we're going to be looking at the floorless coaster design, and we are going to be going through basic elements. We're going to time it to see how long it's going to take, and I'll give you an overhead view so you can count and see if you want to put it in your theme park. Let's get into the video. So today we're going to be looking at a Rougarou clone. Rougarou's at Cedar Point, and we are going to be riding the ride. I'm going to give you a basic tour of it and of the elements, and then we're going to go through them individually so that you may replicate them and replicate this coaster at your theme park in Minecraft. So dip, lift hill, same thing, place a power rail, then three up, and then place another power rail. Same old thing we've been doing. Turn around, we learned that in the four inversion coaster. This time we're going into a giant loop. Giant vertical loop down into a turnaround hill. Hill, turn around into another hill, airtime hill, curving turnaround, curving into a modern loop. Turning around, almost a 270 degree turn, airtime hill, zero G roll, now we're just crawling back to the station, crawling back to the station. Bunny hill, and a few couple of turns back into the station. And we need to put some brakes here. Alright, so basic breakdown of this coaster. I got the lift, you've got the station here, four power rails, you can do four, three to four. Dip, standard lift hill, we already talked about. Up to a turnaround, we talked about it in the four inversion coaster video, down into a drop and into a unique element, the giant vertical loop. As you can see, it is a 5-1-2-5, and then we have a gigantic, we have a 5-2-7 big loop. Remember, back over there, we have a 3-4-3-4. This has a 5-1-2-7, 1-2-5, 1-2-7, then 1-2 back to the 5. Bigger, just needs a little bit more spiral of a turnaround to get to the loop, over the loop, and back down and around. Into a drop, up to a turnaround hill, turnaround, airtime hill, turn around, 270 degree turnaround, into a little powered section to get the train back up to speed, into a more basic loop, not as giant as its bigger cousin over there, modern vertical loop, turn around again, 270 degree turnaround again, airtime hill, zero G roll, turn around, bunny hill, back to the station. So you're probably noticing there's a lot of turnarounds, similar to the racing coaster. That's because these floorless coasters usually have a spaghetti bowl section. Usually they have a big drowned out element, and then they have this kind of conglomerate spaghetti bowl section. You see here, once you get out of the big loop, you go into some turnarounds, a 270 degree turnaround, inversion, turnaround, hill, inversion, turnaround, then a couple of bunny hills back to the station. That is a classic spaghetti bowl station. Floorless coasters are coasters that are like sit-down coasters, but they don't have a floor. Your feet are just dangling in the air as you go through elements. You can take off your shoes and put them away if you think that they're going to fly off. Don't worry, I've never seen it happen on a coaster, on a floorless coaster. They pull incredible forces, but usually they take their elements gracefully as to not have your shoes just whip off. Never seen a coaster actually lose their shoes on a coaster, but have seen someone lose their hat. My dad actually lost their hat, but it wasn't on a floorless coaster. It was on an RMC twister coaster that we will probably build sometime at Sweet World, at Sweet's Adventureland. Anyway, those are basic inversion breakdowns. I don't know what else to show you besides, this is based on Rougarou at Cedar Point. It's a steel conversion coaster. It was converted from a stand-up coaster, which we talked about last episode. We talked about that red coaster over there, that stand-up coaster with a unique support structure. Rougarou used to look like that, but then it was converted into a floorless coaster because stand-up coaster was reportedly too rough. If you've ever been on a stand-up coaster, you either love them or hate them. I'm in the minority camp that loves stand-up coasters, but I do understand why people do find it a bit uncomfortable. Anyway, we're going to do a POV real quick of this coaster, then I'm going to do my spiel because I'm trying to get through these overviews so we can get into actually developing the park. So let's begin the silent POV. We're going to time it, and then that'll be the end of the video, guys. So 3, 2, 1, go. Alright, so now we are back into the station. The ride took 2 minutes, 25 seconds, so a lot longer than the other two coasters we did, the 4 invert and stand up. So yeah, that is the floorless coaster. The only thing to deter a sit down from a floorless coaster is a floorless coaster usually has a spaghetti bowl section with a lot of turnarounds and helixes with inversions splashed in the middle. After a big inversion or a big element, you can make a giant helix if you want to as well if you don't want to do an inversion, but just something giant to get the rider's attention so they want to go on the ride, and then a little twister spaghetti bowl section before coming back to the station. So that's going to do it for this video, guys. I'll see you next time where we'll go over our first, we did our Stratacoaster, so I guess we're going to go over a classic launch coaster variant. And then we're going to go over the last basic design, the last basic coaster design before we start working on Sweet's Adventureland. See you guys later. Like if you like, dislike if you don't, subscribe if you really like it, and I hope you guys have a good day. Toodaloo!